Good morning. Years ago, we decided to take our family of eight to Cape Canaveral to watch the launch of the space shuttle. We bravely boarded the kids and supplies in our van and off we went. We stayed in a hotel, but had to awake at 2 a.m. to again load everyone up and drive over to a specific viewing location across the lake so that we were near enough to see it take off, but far enough away to be protected from the light and the heat. It was amazing. Well, there was a delay, which always makes fun with six tired and cranky kids, but it was so worth it as the countdown began. Then the rocket engines lit up the sky. The smoke billowed, and slowly the shuttle lifted from the ground and took off into space. It was dark that night, but it almost appeared like day when the brightness of the flames filled the sky with light. The earth shook. The sound finally reached us and we felt it. We all stood there captivated as we watched it lift higher and higher until it was finally out of sight. The thousands around us cheered the amazing feat we had just witnessed. In my mind, it is the most profound earthly sight of light that I've ever witnessed. So as we come to Revelation 21, and John describes heaven as filled with the glory of God, he notices that the light for the place, it's not the sun or the moon or the stars, but rather the glory that emanates from God. I have some concept of that picture. The light from the shuttle filled the dark sky as if it was day. So the light from the glory and magnificence of God will fill our heavenly home as if it was always daytime. Okay, Shekinah. It's a Hebrew word that means one who dwells. Coupled with the word glory, the Shekinah glory, that's a term used to describe the visible manifestation of God's presence. It's not specifically in Scripture, but it is described in various places. For example, when God guides his released people from Egypt, he expresses his guidance through a visible cloud during the day and a pillar of fire at night. That's been referred to as the Shekinah glory of God. After Solomon dedicated the temple of God, we read in 2 Chronicles 7:1, "When all the Israelites saw the fire coming down and the glory of the Lord above the temple, they knelt on the pavement with their faces to the ground, and they worshiped and gave thanks to the Lord, saying, 'He is good. His love endures forever.'" Well, in heaven, God's glory will permeate the place and we'll see it and respond with humility and worship and gratitude that we're allowed to be there and experience such glories for all eternity. Now, since we're not there yet, can we experience and reflect at least some measures of God's Shekinah glory? Listen to the scriptures. "Declare his glory among the nations, his marvelous deeds among all peoples." So one way we reflect his glory is to declare it to others, to speak up and speak of the ways that God is glorious, to tell people the marvelous deeds God has done in the cross. I mean, God is glorified as we give witness to the gospel, as well as through our transformed lives. God is glorified when we speak of the scriptures and the prophecies we've been studying in Revelation. So today, speak up and bring God glory. 2 Corinthians 4:6, "For God who said, 'Let light shine out of darkness,' made his light shine in our hearts to give us the light of the knowledge of God's glory displayed in the face of Christ." So when God revealed the gospel to us and saved us by his grace, it brought him glory that we believed in Christ and what God accomplished through his sacrifice. In Luke 2:9, remember that familiar passage we read at Christmas? "An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. Now, I've never had God's glory literally shine around me, but I have had God's glory revealed to my thoughts and heart. I've seen Him work in and through others, in and through me, and I praise Him, and I long for more. Don't you? 2 Corinthians 3:18, "And we all, who with unveiled faces reflect the Lord's glory, are being transformed into His image with ever-increasing glory, which comes from the Lord, who is the Spirit." So I invite you today to reflect upon the Shekinah glory of God, and as you do, let's let Vincent minister to us in this exuberant song that can give us reflections of God's glory and inspire us to do it. So, be blessed.
Stones will start shouting, proclaim the glory of the Lord. With hands uplifted, let us raise immortal praise to Him who reigns on high. He is our Messiah, our Savior.